Hey, I'm here for another round with this Dark Deal combo deck on the play. And this hand is pretty good. I have to decide whether I'm going to Thoughtseize right away or save it until I have Waste not in play. Because I have these Silent Bloods, I think that I can Thoughtseize right away and just make sure that I survive the early game. Alright, I'm going to start off by fetching. I have a bunch of Delve, so I want cards in my graveyard anyway. And I'd rather not draw a Swamp. I do want to draw a blue land, but not a Swamp. Alright. I'm okay with my opponent having Thoughtseize. Tasigur is going to come out pretty early. I'm going to take the Tasigur. I can beat Thoughtseize, Hornet Queen, and Courser, but Tasigur provides the fastest clock, so I'll just take that. I suspect that my opponent will take Waste Knot, but who knows? We will soon find out. Alright, my opponent did in fact taste Waste Knot, but that's fine with me. I get to cast Sign of Blood this turn and Treasure Cruise next turn, so in this Thoughtseize mirror match, so far I'm pretty far ahead. I think that I can wait on the secret until my opponent has fewer cards in hand. Downfall was a great draw. I'm going to get to Downfall the Courser before it generates any. Oh, actually, I'm a mana short of cruising. So I just want to use my mana efficiently. I'm going to secret this turn. And then next turn, I'll either cast Downfall, or I'll also have enough to cast Sign in Blood and Treasure Cruise. Okay, there goes the Queen. That's not surprising. And Murderous Cut. Okay, we'll likely see Courser get played. Revealing a Jungle Hollow. I'm just gonna Downfall it right away. I don't want any funny business. I am missing a land drop, which is unfortunate, but I'll get over that. I'm really restricting my opponent's resources, and letting my opponent get a free land off of Courser is the last thing I want. I can afford to fall back a little bit on board presence, but I want to restrict the number of cards in hand. Okay, I'm going to start off with Sign in Blood, and then I'll probably play Gurmag Angler after that. Ooh, Waste Knot and Dark Deal. That's a combination. Let's see what my opponent plays. Sidisi. But my opponent did not make a zombie. So I like that. I could cast Waste Knot and Dark Deal, but my hand is so good. And I don't think that my opponent's card in hand is that good. So I'm just going to cast Cruise this turn. Bioblight was a great draw. Commune with the gods. Alright, of course, commune will trigger Sidisi. Wow, my opponent is going to get a lot of random, annoying little creatures this turn. Okay, Dark Deal is not really what I have in mind because my hand is so stacked, so I'm going to cast Waste Not, Thoughtseize, and then Bioblight this turn, assuming that I don't draw anything great. Okay, Downfall is good, but it's not going to change my plans. Let's play Waste Not. I will cast Thoughtseize. I will select Doomwake Giant, granting me a zombie. I will kill off this stupid Sidisi, and I'll start attacking the opponent. I quite enjoy playing this deck, it's just pure magic. You know, sometimes the inevitability isn't actually there. I think maybe I should play two Empty the Pits or something like that. Or maybe, yeah, I can't really think of a better card than Empty the Pits. I'll just trade zombies. The opponent's at 11. I'll just take two. I'm winning this race. I will cast Rakshasa's Secret. It's gonna net me as much mana as it costs, or more. All right, my opponent discarded a land. Now I can cast Treasure Cruise. Let's just not do anything. And I'll attack. I'm gonna save the Sign of Blood, I think, to target the opponent to kill him or her next turn. Think that is best. Alright, and I'll just gain a life. Assuming that my opponent draws a blank, I can cast Hero's Downfall, attack for 7, and then cast Sign of Blood. Alright, attacking must mean that my opponent has drawn something. Mana Confluence means Sidisi was drawn. Oh, Torrent Elemental. Oh, Torrent Elemental. attack and sign and blood you. All right. I'm playing against a slow Sidisi whip deck. I might want some negates, and I definitely want another empty the pits. I think that my opponent's going to keep in Murderous Cut and stuff like that, so I don't want to rely too much on the creatures. Though they are fine. Most of the removal is good. Bile Blight is great against Sidisi and Hornet Queen. I might want some ability just to clean up the random stuff like Satyr Wayfinder and other tokens. So I'll bring in a Drown in Sorrow, and I'll be back for the next game.